Hello friends, today I am going to show how to make capsicum stuff. It is very easy to make and it tastes amazing. So let's see how to do it. The ingredients which we need are 3 capsicum, bell peppers, 4 potatoes, 1 teaspoon of cumin seeds, 2 green chilies sliced thin, 1/2 teaspoon of ginger, 1/2 teaspoon of garlic. I haven't taken ginger garlic paste because I want the texture, so it is minced small. Mint leaves, 6 to 8. 1/4 teaspoon of turmeric, 1/4 teaspoon of chili powder, 1/2 teaspoon of garam masala powder or any spice powder which you wish. 1 tablespoon of cilantro, coriander leaf, 1/4 teaspoon of salt, 1 lime and 1 big tomato, and this is 6 to 8 spring onions. You can use red onions if you want, or even you can use the white onions. I like the flavor of this because it goes very mild, so other two are options. And finally the oil, 100 grams. Meanwhile, what we are supposed to do is we have to pressure cook these potatoes, and I am going to blanch the capsicum. Let me show how to do the next steps. Now I'm going to show how to blanch the capsicum. This procedure helps the capsicum to get softened up well, and it'll lose its stiff texture, which will make it easy for us to roast it. So I'm going to pour hot water to a container. You can take a bowl or a container. Then I'm going to drop the capsicum. I can close and keep it for some time, or I can just keep mixing it. We don't want it to get cooked. I can smell the capsicum, so we will keep turning it, not more than 2 to 3 minutes. Now I'm just going to remove the capsicum out of hot water one by one, and I'm going to cut the capsicum in 2 pieces. And I'm going to remove all the seeds inside it and make and give a good shape like a cup, and remove all the seeds. This will act as a natural cup, which will make it easy for us to fill in our stuffing. Cutting a crown and making a hole at the top might be very tricky, so it's easy if we just dig in slightly like this and make a small hole, so which will give a easy push, and this is still okay for us. The hole is not too big and it will be easy for us to do the stuffing. By cutting this way, it will hold on to its shape and roasting becomes more easy. So let me clean this now. Now it will be easy for us to do the filling. So let me show you how to make the potato stuff. I've already boiled and mashed the potatoes. Now I'm going to show how to make the stuff. So take a thick bottom pan and 100 grams of oil. Once the oil warms up, add cumin seeds, onions, saute it for a minute, add green chilies, add minced ginger and garlic, then saute it. After sauteing it for 2 to 3 minutes, I'm going to add the tomatoes. Now let's add the spices. Add turmeric, chili powder, garam masala powder, and mix it well. add the salt. As we can see, the oil oozing out. Now is the time to add the potatoes. Let's mix this well with the potatoes. At this point, if we need, we can add more oil, but it is optional. I'm going to use the masher and mash the potatoes well. Keep mashing it till everything is well incorporated. Now lower the flame, and this would be the time to adjust the salt and the spices. So now it's almost done. We are going to add the mint and half of the cilantro which we had saved, and mix it well. Now the potato stuffing is ready to be stuffed in the capsicum. So now let us start filling the stuff inside the capsicum. The capsicum which had a crown which we filled is going to look like this. You can just pat it, and this is going to roast and it is going to be very crunchy and tasty. Now let's fill the rest of the capsicums. I'm going to fill the last one now. You can take the bread knife and give it a soft edge. The leftover potato mix can be used as a cutlet or a filler for a sandwich or even for a burger or maybe even for the paratha. So now let's proceed to roast the capsicum. I have taken the cast iron pan and it is warmed up, and I have just greased it slightly with oil. If I want, I can add more. This will give very nice roast for the potatoes. I'm going to put 3 capsicum at a time. Now let's check and turn it. And now let it sit and roast the bottom part for again 4-5 minutes. Now the bottom is roasted, I'm going to roast the corners. So with the support of the middle capsicum, I'm going to roast the corners. You can roast it as per your taste and needs. And blanching the capsicum always gives it a good flavor and texture. It stays crunchy and it also adds good aroma. So now the capsicum stuff is almost ready. Now let's garnish. I have arranged it now. Let me garnish it with cilantro and the lime and the capsicum stuff is ready to be served. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe to Charya's Kitchen for more videos, tips and tricks. Thank you.